Hello, my dear friends. I welcome all the students of 8th standard in the online session of D.A.V. Moyle Public School, Sita Savangi. Today, the topic for the subject science is microorganism, our friends and foes. That is chapter number 2. We have seen a large number of plants and animals around us. Besides this, there are large number of small organisms which cannot be seen with our naked eyes. However, they can easily be observed through the microscope. So, these living organisms that are invisible to the naked eye but are visible under the microscope are called microorganisms, and their study is known as microbiology. My dear friends, microorganisms include viruses and single-celled organisms like bacteria, yeast, protozoa, algae. Each of these group of microorganisms include some harmful as well as some useful organisms. Before that, have you ever had a thought who might have invented the microscope? Yes, Antony van Leeuwenhoek has discovered the microscope. This is one of the sample of the early time microscope which has been used for watching small microorganisms. Microorganisms are the oldest form of life on the earth. So there are 4 types of microorganisms: bacteria, fungi, algae and protozoa. On the basis of their cell structure, microorganisms can be divided into 4 groups. Some of these microorganisms are shown as such. These are different type of bacteria. This is Staphylococcus, one of the type of bacteria. Yes, these are different type of fungus. As you can see, mushroom is also one of the type of fungus. And the fungus that you have observed on the bread is also a type of fungus which is called as bread mold. Yeast is also a type of fungus which is used for fermentation. Protozoa is one of the type of microorganism in which you can see rhizopoda, amoeba, paramecium are different type of microorganism protozoa. These are different type of algae. Basically, chlorella and spirogyra are different type of algae. So, my dear friends, viruses are also considered as microorganisms. They are different from other microorganisms because they reproduce only in the body of host organism like bacteria, plant or animal. So, we can say that viruses are unique. Viruses are the living organisms and they are not found in non-living thing like salt and sugar. In fact, they can be crystallized and stored in jar for years. But when they come in contact with a suitable plant, animal or bacteria, they shows the characteristics of living organism. So they infect the cell and quickly multiply itself. Therefore, they are considered on the borderline between living and non-living thing. Have you ever had a thought where do the microorganisms live? Microorganisms can be found almost in every kind of environment, like in ice cold water, hot spring and in dry marshy saline area. Microorganisms can be found in any place like floor, or in high in the atmosphere. It can also be found in any of the home utility, home utensils, while on the ocean floor, high in the atmosphere and deep inside the rock. Within the earth crust, microorganisms are also found in the human body and in the body of other plant and animal. Mouth, throat, nose and alimentary canal are all inhabited by large number of microorganisms. Thus, microorganisms are found everywhere. Now, what is the role of microorganism in our life? Microorganisms play an important role in our life and in the environment. They help in the decomposition process and in maintaining the biochemical cycle, like the carbon and nitrogen cycle. They are useful and beneficial for mankind in many ways. However, some of them are harmful as they cause disease and even spoil food. Microorganisms are also found in the human body. The human body is inhabited by millions of tiny living organisms, which altogether are called as human microbiota. Bacteria are microbes found on the skin, in the nose, mouth, and especially in the guts. We acquire this bacteria during birth and the first year of the birth, and they live with us throughout our life. So, my dear friends, microorganisms are very small and cannot be seen by the naked eye. Also, microorganism may be unicellular or multicellular, and microorganism may exist alone or in the colonies. Microorganisms are found in all kind of environment, like cold, hot, desert and marshy area. In the next lecture, we will learn about microorganism as our friends. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.